My father gave me my first taste of plumbing before I was even old enough to read a manual. But as a toddler, you just have a sense for how long and thick a pipe will be.
Yeah. On my 13th birthday, I got my first toilet tank that I was able to take apart and reassemble.
Oh, God, in high school, I was still into tankless heaters. No, it's true. I was still calling bituminous tubes orange burps. Isn't that pathetic?
You see this? This is your standard triple extension assembly. And what's so beautiful about this baby is that you can open a valve here or here or here, and the water will come up straight up out of that tube from your control transformer, which is down here, around here somewhere, and it comes right out of your faucet or your distribution chamber. Either one. And I love that. I love that about this thing. It's incredible.
I came from a good family. I mean, I was weaned on bathroom fixtures and sinks. It never occurred to me that someone I knew so well could have such a dark secret.
Brad Riley. So you want to know about Brad, huh?
Brad and I grew up together. We were best friends. We used to hang out on weekends in the cesspool behind my grandpa's chicken house. But it was a simpler time.
I mean, you have to understand, I mean, the only things we cared about were beer, women, and plumbing. And that's it.
We were the cool clique. Just having fun, going with the flow.
You'd look at Brad, and you'd never know that he was hiding something.
Brad Riley was definitely the most popular boy in school. Mm. He could handle anything, forced hot water systems, drainage lines.
And Brad was very hot.
Every girl in school had a thing for Brad. He knew the minimum offsets for a quarter-inch spigot fitting. Unfortunately, the only guy who paid attention to us was the captain of the football team.
Hi, Molly. Would you go out with me?
Get a wrench. Men are such jerks.
If only they could all be like Brad.
He is such a good plumber.
I had a major crush on Brad. Now, of course, it all seems trivial. But back then, he was the world to me. He was sweet and handsome. One vacation, I remember he built this acid-diluting tank with fine-tooth washers. I mean, who would think of that? I was hopelessly in love.
But I never suspected a thing.
At first, I thought he was just losing his interest in central hot water systems. But it turned out that he wasn't interested in water at all. He had a secret passion that no one knew about. What's supposed to happen to someone like that?
So one day, I was shopping after school, and it all came clear to me.
For those of you who remember the old days of the Fosbury Drainage Maintenance Manual, you're in for a treat. Reprints of the Fosbury Manual are available in aisle 2. Flipping through the pages proves to be a walk down memory lane. Who can forget old favorites like the plunger procedure chapter or that infamous diagram, common 5 sizes?
Brad? I couldn't believe it. My Brad was in aisle 6. I mean, our families belonged to the same church. I'd walked by aisle 6 a million times, but I never dare go down it. That moment, I saw a new side of Brad. Exotic and wild, yet also vulnerable. I wanted to be a part of it. I mean, his eyes seemed to say, "Madeline, let me show you my world."
Morning sun, you know the door to my very soul. You're the light in my deepest, darkest doubt. You're my savior when I fall. And you may not think I care for you when you know down inside that I really do. And it's me you need to show. How deep is your love? Is your love?
Nice. Basically, Brad was getting really weird.
Read it and weep. The absolute minimum fall or grade for foundation or subsoil drainage lines is 1 inch in 20 feet. 20 feet busted. Pay up.
Okay, but I hadn't seen the revised manual when I said that, so how was he supposed to know, right?
You gotta know the revised manual if you want to get any of the good schools.
I'll learn it. I just hadn't seen it before we made our little
bet. What were you doing when it came out?
What, were you too busy wearing your electric bus?
Shut up, Jeff.
Is that what you were doing? Are you an electrician? You like fuses?
Yeah, yeah. What's the deal? Yeah, what's the deal here, man? Are you sitting in your room wiring circuits?
Yeah,
who are you? Big fat electrician, aren't you, Pat?
Yeah, I'm a big fat electrician.
Well, why don't you show me your little pluggies, huh? That'll give us a charge, won't it? Come on,
man.
Can
you see my jacket and take a look?
You got any fuses in there, too?
Let me see.
Because I can't find them. I can't find them.
Oh,
yeah? Maybe you have some electrical tape.
Maybe.
Take it easy, Eddie.
Brad? Brad? She was just kidding around.
I remember the day he confessed to us, but what are you supposed to say when someone just point blank tells you that he's a kite and a key type?
Have you ever noticed how a circuit is connected to the fuse box in your house? I'm serious. All my life I've spent trying to perfect my flush valve technique. You know, working with water systems with all you guys. When, I don't know. The truth, I knew there was something else for me. Electricity.
What kills me is that all this time we thought he was our buddy and he was a fucking dick.
I was shocked when I found out. It just blew the knob off my nozzle.
He didn't enter anything for Plumfest.
The boy was going crazy, you realize that?
He was jumping off the deep end.
And Madeline was getting sucked into his evil spell. I remember I asked her if she thought this whole thing was really worth it.
Madeline? Do you think this whole thing is really worth it?
At the time, I thought the whole thing was really worth it. I mean, it was risky, rebellious, dangerous. Things started to get out of hand. I mean, we were actually wiring things in my house while my parents were downstairs. Madeline!
Okay!
I'll get it, honey.
And one night, Brad's parents were over for dinner.
Well, Penny! Brad!
My mom was looking for a tablecloth, and she found a box of our electrical tools.
Don't be silly, Judy. The carpenters probably left the box in there by accident.
I know. But I'm worried.
Madeline is such a sweet young woman. There's just no reason she'd get involved in anything so slimy.
Now that you mention it, Marcia, I do remember seeing your son Brad with Madeline at the hardware store last week. And I could swear they were in aisle 6.
He was pushing me over the edge. I mean, this wiring stuff was a thrill for a while, but enough was enough. My friends were only so patient. And then our parents, the first time at the table together.
So, Bradley, I understand you've been seeing a lot of our daughter.
Yes, sir. Well, she's great. I like her a lot.
I don't recall her telling us which college you were going to go to, though.
Go ahead, son. Tell us where you're going.
I guess, I want to go to MIT. You know, I'm not interested in water systems, pipes. It doesn't do it for me. I'm sorry, Dad. It's not that I don't like that. No, wait, yes, it is. I don't like it at all. I don't like plumbing at all. What it is, I want to work with circuits and wires, yeah. With plugs, sockets.
Oh, come on, son, you don't think you can actually...
do think that I can actually do it. Yeah,
Brad, it's just a phase, dear.
It's not a phase. Okay, I don't want to be a plumber. I want to be an electrical engineer.
Damn it the hell, young lady. I don't know what kind of volte you're involved with. Hey, watch what you say about my son, asshole. Your daughter's no Farrah Fawcett.
Hey, Dad, you leave Madeline out of it, okay? Just leave her out.
I'll kill you, Madeline.
Don't
kill you,
threaten her, okay? You don't do that.
My parents were just concerned about me. They just cared about me. This isn't easy for me to go over again, you know.
Show it.
Oh. Oh. Yes.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh, what I would pay for just one night to work on that. Whoa.
Madeline's been one to experiment, but she's always come to her senses in the end. It was difficult for her to take that step, but she's tough, like a hairball in a feed water tank. And I love her for that.
Me too.
Jeff has always been there for me. Well, he always understood, but he's not... Brad.
He was a sick, sick, very sad... very sick, very pitiful piece of sink cheese.
And then he had the gall to show up at school the next day.
And what are we supposed to say to him? Hello? How are you, Brad, Mr. Electric Man? Give me a goddamn break.
Dick.
Dick. Penis.
Dick.
Madeline, I love you. I'll change.
I'm sorry, Brad.
If I hadn't walked away that day, things might have been very different.
He never went to MIT.
No.
He seemed to give up his silly obsession and go back to plumbing. 100%.
Just to win Madeline back.
He became a damn good plumber. But like a Hinckley sprinkler valve, once you stray from your roots, you can never go back.
I guess not.
Madeline would deny this, but in the years after high school, she considered going back to Brad many times. He seemed like a changed man. But you know what happened then.
Brad?
Yeah, Carl.
Mrs. Feldman called about the fugulator, and light bulbs came for the window outside.
Hey, Dan.
Thank you.
rise in the morning sun. You know the door to my very soul. You're the light in my deepest, darkest doubt. You're my savior when I fall. And you may not think I care for you when you know down inside that I really do. And it's me you need to.
Please stop the camera. Please throw the camera off.
I miss him. I really do.
He had it coming.
I guess you're right.
He was a good plumber, though.
I just thought it was Faze. I mean, he opened the store.
Oh, he never could have been happy. Brad had it all, but it was never enough. And now he's dead.
So then she says, "Spigot, what manual are you reading?"
Oh, that's a good one.
How about you, Jerry?
My first time?
Let me see.
Oh, I remember. I was 14 years old.
14?
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Anyway, I was over at Nancy Brandon's house. The folks were away for the weekend. So she tells me to come into the kitchen. I'm thinking, kitchen? Needless to say.